Tonight's event is the Ladies Individual Apparatus Championships, where the European Cup winner will be decided. A bevy of gymnasts, the cream of Europe. This, the final of the season, other than the World Students Games, which is being held in Buffalo next weekend. All of the gymnasts can hang up their leotards for a summer break.
À la poutre juge expert, Madame Benke, et conseillère technique scientifique, c'était aussi le cas de Madame Bordeaux, pardon, Madame Milo.
This is a final of the European Cup. There have been, since October last year and until May this year, 8 qualifying rounds. And these are the 14 of the 16 finalists. The nations had to qualify for at least 2 of the 8 events. And they collected points by the first getting 20 points down to the 14th gathering a point. And of course they're ranking in world and European championships alongside those qualifying rounds gave them points also. Taking a look now at the judges. Gymnasts preparing now for the event. Everard there from Belgium. The girls having 4 disciplines, unlike the men who have 6. Starting on vault, then going to asymmetric bars, and the dreaded beam, and then the floor exercises, which really such a spectacle and quite a favorite amongst the viewers. Benedict Everard preparing for her first discipline. And just a little regime of strengthening there from her coach. The men's event, very exciting. The ex-Soviet gymnasts taking the 3 medals, Karabianko being the winner. And now Klára Kuldakova from the Czech Republic to vault. In most competitions, the female gymnasts have 2 vaults and the better of the 2 scores. But in this competition, the average of the 2 score. So really, it's most important that the gymnasts have 2 sound vaults. Without that, their marks are really going to plummet. The gymnasts are now working on the new code of points, which is, of course, the ruling for international gymnastics. In fact, that is Klára Kuldakova performing her first vault. Yurchenko start with a half twist and handspring front dismount from the horse. That's the first of 2. Now the gymnast can opt to do the same vault again and try and perform it a little better, or they can change the vault. They have 2 options. But I think now having a decent one in the bag, all that Klára will need to do is try and do it that little bit better. The gymnasts working to the new code of points as from the 1st of January this year. And very strict it is too, especially on the landing. There she was under-rotated and had to step back, although she didn't move the anchor foot. Score for the first vault, 9.562. Not bad at all. But that a better vault. Much better. Not under-rotated. Spotted the landing far more confidently. There's the Arab spring, the half twist on. The handspring, it's a 1.5 somersault actually, because it comes from the hands. Quite a heavy cowboy tuck, and obviously she's not being penalized too heavily for it, coming out with the score she did. And on the computer, her final score tells me is 9.618. And over to the asymmetric bars, and Maya Shani from Israel, 14-year-old, trains in Tel Aviv. Jaeger into the hop change. Just a little bit lethargic, lacking the sparkle and speed, and double layout dismount. But wonderful to see gymnasts from Israel ranking so highly in world gymnastics. In fact, Maya Shani coming fifth in the junior European championships. Tanya Pechstein. Tanya from Switzerland. She has a new move in the competition, which we're looking forward to seeing, called the Pechstein somersault, the dismount from the asymmetric bars. Her first vault, quite safe, but pretty uninspiring. It's a Cuervo. That's a handspring entry. And after leaving the apparatus, performing the half twist and the back somersault. Admittedly, in slow motion, the faults appear to be magnified. It is judged at the speed of the human eye, not at the speed of the slow motion camera, which in many cases is fortunate for the gymnast. 0.45, second to come. Oof. And she really, I think, intended to try it pike, but she really did plummet down, totally lacking in rotation. First the better of the two, but of course the average to count, so she could have done with lifting that second vault. And a cheer from the home crowd for Benedict Evrard, 18-year-old Belgian student and the best gymnast produced in Belgium for many years. The giant full turn. Kachev into back straddle to handstand. And gymnastics is all about linking together the difficulties. Doing them individually isn't sufficient. The standard is so high. Well spotted double layout dismount. A clean exercise, but even though that looked pretty difficult, against today's opposition, she's going to struggle to meet the 9.5 barrier. Quite clean. There's one of the giants with the full pirouette. And from another angle, the dismount double layout, but can see that she would incur a penalty for the split legs, but the split legs enabled her to have a controlled landing. What we saw at the opening of the program actually was this vault of Ivanova's. In slow motion, and it was a replay. And that first vault of hers scored her 9.462. Ivanova, old by standards of today's gymnast. She's 19, but very, very slender. Only weighs 44 kilos, very light. Of course, making her gymnastics easier. Yurchenko with a full twist. Of course, the innovator of the Yurchenko was Natalia Yurchenko. Soviet gymnast who first performed the vault back in 1983. Ekaterina Vandysheva from Russia on the A-bars, brilliant gymnast, hop change, what a wonderful combination. Full twist into Jaeger. Stolder on the bottom bar, arm bend though, get a penalty and for the jump off the bottom bar, but wonderful shapes. Double layout.
Also, Yelena Piskun.
The closed shoulder giant preparing for the whip into the double dismount. But her compatriot later on, seen in warm-up, actually does this beautifully straight. Yelena Piskun. Oh, double twisting Yurchenko. Only 15 from Belarusia. Startling prospect. Just managing to wrap that second twist in, rather late in starting to twist. Could have done with a little bit more arm width to accelerate the twist and get round with more ease. But nevertheless, a very difficult vault. Always looks under stress. She really has got some extremely difficult work in her repertoire. And I think the mode nowadays is much more to compete with what the gymnast can cope with readily. And I have that distinct feeling that Piskun is under a tremendous amount of pressure. 9.762 for the first vault. Not a bad start. Yes, it was just about on the cards, really. She didn't quite get the right angle of strike into the flick-flack, in effect. And instead of lifting, she was always beating into somersault and really didn't have time to lift from the apparatus. Oksana Fabrichnova. Startling little gymnast from Russia. Leonid Arkiev spotting her there for her ginga. Coaches are allowed to be there as long as they don't touch. Just popped the Katcheva in very easily. But that is the spectacular aspect of the routine. Pull in, pull out. That's two somersaults and two twists. And that's one big dismount. And I don't think we'll be seeing another one of those. And just watch the height of it as she releases, if we're fortunate enough to see it in slow motion. Way above the bar. Just about above the bar as she finishes her second twist. And that really denotes years of training. And there's the leaderboard. Vandysheva in the lead with 9.675. Fabrichnova with 9.625. And Kudilkova from the Czech Republic, 9.618.
Fin de l'échauffement. First vault. For Gabriela Shmarova.
Now into the warm-up, preparing for the second rotation. And that was Gabriela Kramarova. Not exactly the second rotation, but because the groups are fairly large, the gymnasts have been divided down so that only four of them are expected to wait for their competition. Kramarova looks a little bit perturbed, obviously jarred her back on landing. First vault, 9.562. But she looks distinctly uncomfortable. This is the Yurchenko half on, handspring 1.5 off, and she came in under rotated. And again, the floor hit her rather than her hitting the floor. So that'll drop her average down, because she'll lose a compulsory 5/10 for sitting down on the landing. Chiara Ferrazzi from Italy, preparing on the A-bars for her first discipline. Giant full twist, half twist, forward giant, Voronin hop. And the undershoot over the bottom bar. The gymnasts have to have two bar changes. Flight over the bar. The dismount, at least a B, but we're looking at a D dismount there. Full twisting double to dismount. And it almost puts that dismount into insignificance, having seen Fabrichnova do that full in, full out. There, the full in, back somersault out, under rotated, causing her to step forwards. In picture now, 18-year-old Andrea Molnar. There are two Molnars in the Hungarian team, and this is the oldest of the two, and contrary to opinion, they're not twins. Full twisting Yurchenko. A little bit slack around the knees, but dynamically a good vault, good distance and good height from the apparatus. Andrea went to school and always trained with the great Henrietta Anodi. Of course, Henrietta now retired. And so Andrea and Christina Molnar having to carry the Hungarian flag. But great ambassadors for the country, two great girls. Second vault a little bit tighter than the first. Knees not quite so slack, and a well-controlled landing. Perhaps more apparent in this slow motion. Good distance and well-spotted landing. And now to a very special gymnast from the Ukraine, 15-year-old Lilia Podkopayeva. Fabulous gymnast, just watch the special shapes that she achieves. Clear circle, hecht. Beautiful lines. Full twisting hop. Full twisting giant. Ginga. Just tapped the floor with her feet there, so she'll have a penalty and for the bent arms there on that stalled a circle. But what a prospect she is. Light, wonderfully tensioned, and that is a double back straight. So often, we commentators refer to an open or a layout somersault as straight, and we're really not being definite enough. But I can assure you that that was straight. Well, perhaps slightly dished, but certainly not arched. And the very popular Lavinia Milosovici 17-year-old. Several looks at the shapes of Milosevic in her handspring, piked front with the half twist. Milosevic had a very bad World Championships this year, finishing down in eighth position, but she still holds a world title on the beam and an Olympic title on the floor, and she's really being pushed by these young gymnasts here today. Lots of forward momentum, not a lot of lift, thus giving an unsteady landing. Octavian Belou, the coach for Milosevic. And Podkopayeva's score, 9.55, obviously paying the price of skimming the floor with her feet. Stovbchataya, Ludmila Stovbchataya from the Ukraine to the asymmetric bars. Could have been an error. Just stopped in that handstand. Could have been an escape route because some of these gymnasts are so clever in arranging their routines. Full twisting giant, double back piked. I would suspect that that went a little bit wrong and it was very, very well disguised, but the judges can only mark on what they see. A rather ungainly double back pike. She closed her ankle angle as she closed her hip angle. But the first rotation over with and the final of this European Cup well underway. Some fabulous talent from the Ukraine and Belarus and Russia. Now that the ex-Soviet Union has been split into states, we have so many more quality gymnasts present in the European events. But three more disciplines to go. And then tomorrow, the individual apparatus finals. There's the leaderboard. Milosevic in the lead. Vandysheva second, Molnar third, Fabrichnova fourth, Kudlikova from the Czech Republic fifth. But join us for more, the second round, shortly after the break. See you in a moment.
Eurosport.
And welcome back for your sports coverage in artistic gymnastics. And this is the third European Cup from Brussels, and in picture Ekaterina Vandysheva from Russia. Flick, layout, layout, and that is quite some opening. Corbett flick, first performed by Olga Corbett back in 76, and a well-used element. Oh dear, what a shame. Gain a flick, half turn into Tinska, and of course a compulsory 5/10 for falling from the apparatus. But Ekaterina, one of the most stylish gymnasts that I've seen in quite some time. And we've had some wonderful gymnastics to watch over the years. That's not taking away from many of the brilliant gymnasts. But a little bit of the finesse had gone. The beauty of the straight legs had been overtaken by the difficulty of the skill. And Vandysheva putting all that right and then losing it on that fall. Arab Spring, flick, double back. And what a brilliant recovery she made. Fell off, got back on and didn't even wobble. Second look at the mount.
Ivanova, 8,787.
Yurchenko mount, followed by a flick, and then two layouts.
Piskun.
Yelena Piskun from Belarus. And she really has a very difficult routine. Oh, dear me. Full twisting ginga, or delf, as it's called. Because a ginga already has a half twist in it. And she really did take a bad tumble. Very cleverly fallen, though. She turned her shoulder into the floor. It could have been a disaster. What a shame. Such a lovely gymnast. But she has to get on and recover. And I don't think she has. Caught the Aegis somersault well, but put in several extra swings, and really she's out of it now. Tenths gone, because 5/10 for the fall and 3/10 for the extra swing. And so she'll be down to the mid-eights.
Nu volgt Oksana Fabrichnova.
Oksana Fabrichnova. Tiny little gymnast, weighs only 34 kilos, 14 years old, and she really can produce some difficulty. Lovely neck kip there. A compulsory 360 degree turn, which is always followed by a little bit of a hesitation. Leap combination. There are compulsory elements that gymnasts must fulfill. Acrobatic series, gymnastic and acrobatic series, and gymnastic series. Gymnastics, of course, being dance. And another big dismount from her. Arab Spring, full in, back out. And very matter-of-fact about it as well. Not that it's that easy for her, but with feet her size, some of our larger gymnasts can make some excuses, because the beam must seem particularly wide for her. Yelena Piskun there, suffering with the shoulder injury. Rumour has it that she may well call it a day. Jerked her shoulder rather badly on landing. Gabriela Kramarova from the Czech Republic to the asymmetric buzz. She's got a little bit of a back niggle. Full giant into ginga. Bit messy around the legs. And it's a good job that wasn't the coach willing her through, because the judges could have given her a penalty for communicating. But obviously somebody's strategically placed in the crowd. The cameraman took rather a long time to move and let us have a full view of the dismount. Very disconcerting for the judges.
alla poutre Chiara Ferrazzi.
Chiara Ferrazzi from Italy. To beam. Looks very much like Lisa Grayson, a British gymnast from 2 or 3 years ago. And I don't really think that the judges can give that as a gym acro combination. Change leg, split leap into jump. Back walk over into a flick, rather into tucked Corbett. And really quite a few stops and starts after the elements. And I think that her score will manifest those penalties. And that looked very uncomfortable indeed. Full twisting Corbett. She must be off the beam before the final whistle. Well, she held everything, but there was just an amount of hesitation suggesting that she was nervous. And once you get on the beam and get a fit of the wobbles around the legs, it's so difficult. That causes the adrenaline to flow, and too much adrenaline causes your heartbeat to go up, and it's really hard to control. But unfortunately, Ferrazzi suffering from nerves. And there the leaderboard, Fabrichnova in the lead, a clear lead of 19.4, Vandysheva. And there the leaderboard, Fabrichnova in the lead, a clear lead of 19.4, Vandysheva. Also from Russia, 18.825. Kramarova from the Czech Republic, 18.631. And of course, we haven't seen all of the gymnasts yet. Andrea Molnar from Hungary, midway through a routine. Would have been better to see all of the routine than the scoreboard. There the catcher. And the coach making himself scarce, building up. Now for the dismount. Pull him back out. And the demands of the code on asymmetric bars, particularly very difficult. Lilia Podkopayeva from the Ukraine over to beam. Her second discipline. Ludmila from Odessa, where she trains. Nice combination there. I'm sure that would count, that front somersault into a jump. And a half pirouette on headstand to chest roll. Lovely cast up to handstand. Podkopayeva finishing there with a full in back out. I think I'm establishing her as one of my favorite gymnasts. Very much my type of gymnast, beautiful quality of movement. Octavian Ballou preparing the asymmetric bars. The gymnasts can have the bars, you see the handles winding the distance between the high and the low bar. They can have them at the distance they wish, but the height is specified, the top bar 2.30 meters and the bottom bar 1.50 meters. Lavinia Milosevic starting there with a chapuznik of a mount. Ginger edging her way to the center of the bar where she gets the most performance out of it. Forward giant and double front. Ooh. Really under rotated. Milosevic there doing the Mercer dismount, innovated by British gymnast Sarah Mercer. Look at the blind change into the double front away, which really was under rotated and she was in bother all the time. Ludmila Stovbchataya from the Ukraine to beam. And she hasn't forgotten to fasten her leotard at the back. It's very much the fashion of these gymnasts. I know in my gym, the girls very rarely keep the neck fastened on the high neck leotards because it makes them feel as though they're choking. Sometimes wonder why they choose the fashion. Nice combination. Backflip, full twisting, Corbett. Lili spin. Of course, Lili, the little Chinese girl performing it first in Seoul. And Stovbchataya looks much heavier than she really is. I've seen her in Birmingham. And I'm sure she hasn't put that much weight on since then, but the elastic that they wear underneath their leotards sometimes isn't quite as flattering as it's intended because it makes quite a crease around their waist instead of just leaving the natural female lines. Full in, back out. In a piked position. And Klára Kuldíková from the Czech Republic to the asymmetric bars. There the ginger. Getting through with full complement. Of course, in competition two, having to have a D.
9.762.
Landing rather straight-legged.
Shani.
It's a good job she had her hips sticking out backwards, otherwise she could have really jarred her back. Shani from Israel on beam. Back walk of a flick flick. Sorry, I glanced down. I think that was flick layout layout. Arab Spring whip back, a very bold combination. Certainly not short of difficulty. But unfortunately, the lack of confidence on her landings, waving her arms around. All those little tenths count against her. But of course, at only 14, great experience for her. Well spotted there. Double back dismount. And we're very, very fortunate in this competition to see so much difficulty. Get rather complacent when we only see a double back tucked after we've been watching double backs with full twists in them. Now the gymnasts rotating, preparing for their third discipline. The leaderboard to date. Fabrichnova still up there with 19.4, but Andrea Molnar's climbed up from Hungary, Podkopayeva from the Ukraine, and Stovbchataya from the Ukraine up in fourth position.
Le classement après deux rotations. Omar Kouar.
So the top few places. Still quite close. Vandysheva. And Ekaterina qualified for this European Cup in the Moscow event where she was fourth all around. Trains. It's the Central Army Club in Moscow. 1.5 twist walkout, double twist punch front. And that's the one of the compulsory elements, the three leap series. Despite being a voluntary competition, there are certain elements on all disciplines that are required. Two and a half twist punch front. But most of the gymnasts actually perform three tumbles and only two are necessary. But it's particularly difficult on this new code of points to score on the gymnastic elements. They're the 1.5 twist walkout, double twist and punch front. And Vandysheva's score, 9.575.
For injury.
Yelena Piskun, who fell so tragically from the asymmetric bars. She's had to withdraw because of an injury to her shoulder. And now we have Oksana Fabrichnova, the leader of the competition so far. She qualified for this final by competing in Moscow and Rome, where she won the all-around event in both cases. Another replay of Vandysheva's floor routine. Obviously the judges aren't quite ready and the producer feels it necessary to keep us entertained. And there again the score coming up. I'd already seen it on my computer. Fabrichnova to floor, the leader of the competition so far. 14-year-old from Dynamo, fifth in the World Championships. cameraman looks as though he's lying down for a rest. Ah. Lovely. Handspring, full twisting, front, punch tucked. Whip, flick, double tuck. And just for good measure, another full in, back out to finish.
Oksana Fabrichnova.
And who says that gymnastics is an anaerobic sport? The gymnasts really do need to be fit.
On the beam now, representing
the training required to produce these tumbles really is aerobic, whilst the event themselves may not be. Gabriela Kramarova from the Czech Republic. I was about to say mounting, but falling as well. And what a dreadful place to fall on the mount. I just hope she can manage to get over the anticipation of a second fall. Just not believing in herself. The flick whip somersault there was perfectly down the center, but just didn't believe she could land it. But she's got the right attitude, very business-like attitude, moving through the exercise briskly.
But we are waiting first for the quotation of Oksana Fabrichnova. Het is wachten op de quotering van Fabrichnova.
I don't quite know who we're going to see. Whether we're going to see Ferrazzi or Andrea Molnar.
9.65.
Chiara Ferrazzi to floor.
Voor haar grondoefening de Italiaanse Chiara Ferrazzi.
Thank you. Some pity there about the fall on the final tumble. Double-handed touch, actually bearing weight on hands, depending on how favorably the judges see it, can lose 3/10, if not more.
Now on the beam, Andrea Molnar.
Andrea mounting there with the front somersault. Nice gainer, straight to one. And that a controlled full spin. Andrea ranked 11th in the world in the all-around championships back in Birmingham in April. And she's quite a personality. Absolute movie fanatic. Any spare time she's got. And perhaps she's been watching too many. Perhaps she should have done more repetitions on that layout. Gymnasts really should be penalised. Their weight up to 2 seconds for a concentration pause. They can lose marks, and I'm sure the judges are quite generous. They give as much leeway as they can. Where she came to grief on that double layout. It really went wrong on the landing of the second one, where she opened her hip angle and tried to rescue it. But she made amends here. A really well-spotted double back dismount. Knew exactly where the floor was there. Oh, what a spectacular opening tumble there from Podkopayeva. Out of the floor, costs her a tenth. Obviously, quite tired in the corner, rather a long time before this final tumble. But she really does have long flicks and long fly springs. Beautiful full in, back out. And really an exciting prospect. Just have a break and we'll leave this competition in its third rotation. But remember to join us for the finishing stages, because we do have some brilliant prospects in this European Gymnastics Cup. So on this slow motion replay, we'll leave you. Come back soon. And welcome back to the European Cup from Brussels, Artistic Gymnastics, and we're joining the world champion on beam at the moment, Lavinia Milosovic. but she really is being pushed by the Russian and Ukrainian gymnasts in this European Cup. Nice high double back dismount there from Lavinia. Skill for skill on beam, Podkopayeva and Fabrichnova have overtaken her, but the dismount there, despite not having a twist in it, was beautifully lifted. Stovbchataya to floor. It's her third rotation. Ooh, just inside on that full in back out piked. Ludmilla's from Odessa. And she's 19 and been an international gymnast since 89.
Et également pour Milosovici, la plus haute cote de la soirée provisoirement avec 9.775.
Podkopayeva on floor 9.55 and Lavinia Milosevic on beam 9.775, and dare I say it, a very generous mark for her. Andrea Molnar 9.2 on beam. And now to Klára Kuldilková from the Czech Republic. Klára, in fact, 17, but 18 this week. This competition also the qualifier for tomorrow's individual apparatus championships, where Klára could do very well actually on the vault, because in Birmingham she managed to get into an individual apparatus final. So quite apparent that her best discipline, and in fact her favorite discipline, is vault. Confident double back dismount, and like all gymnasts, she's very happy to have beam under her belt. And what's more, having landed everything safely, and that to her was obviously a personal triumph, and this is very important. We'll take a break now. Join us in a moment.
Euro.
And welcome back to the all-around event in the European Cup. This artistic gymnastics and the gymnast on the floor, Maya Shani from Israel. Kuldilkova, who we saw shortly before the break on beam, scored 9.425. And that put her in eighth position. Israel's Maya Shani. Had a very good competition so far. 9.643 on vault, 9.487 on asymmetric bars, 9.45 on beam. And as soon as I know her floor score, I'll let you have it. That, in fact, isn't Tanya Pechstein. This is on beam. Tanya from Switzerland, lying in 12th place. Side semi, very difficult to move. Not one that many gymnasts choose to put in their routine, because coping with somersault and half a twist, or quarter of a twist in actual fact, on beam isn't too easy. Flick split jump, and not a very good combination there. Oh dear. Judging from the way in which she jumped off, she must have been well and truly off balance on that front somersault. Chain leg split into pike jump. She went amiss in her competition on the asymmetric bars, but 9.356 on vault, and her fall on bars cost her. She dropped down to 8.862 on beam. Rather wobbly, so she'll be lucky to see a 9, and on floor 8.325, so she must have had a fall there. Benedict Evrard from Belgium, lying in ninth place, doing very well indeed. Double layout. Looked as though she could have stepped out of the area. sorry for the momentary loss of picture. I'm experiencing the same as you, undoubtedly. Well, definitely out of the floor area there, and a definite tenth gone, and earlier on she may well have stepped out after her second tumble, but that was Belgium's Benedict Everard, 9.587 on vault, 9.35 on asymmetric bars, and 9.262 on beam. Not a bad set of scores. And that the double layout where she could have stepped out earlier. This the double back tucked, and she really didn't quite approach the diagonal thoroughly enough. Leaderboard, Fabrichnova in the lead. Milosevic hauled up to second position. And Podkopayeva from the Ukraine. And Stovbchataya very, very close in there in third and fourth, so it'll be interesting to know who gets the bronze medal between those two. But we'll be into the fourth rotation. We'll take a short break, so come back. And welcome back to the final stages of the European Cup in Artistic Gymnastics from Brussels. And Oksana Fabrichnova to vault this, her fourth piece. She's the leader in the competition. Looks very much like she could take the title. But there's been some stiff opposition on vault. Two vaults. That was the first. She has another one to come, and it's really important that she puts in, if possible, a better performance. There, slow motion of her first vault. Meanwhile, into her second. Really bouncy little thing, rebounding from the floor on the landing from that Yurchenko with a full twist. And the reason they do that is that they're holding such tension as they strike the floor that it's very difficult to time and absorb the landing.
...775 voor de eerste.
Podkopayeva. Oh, nice vault. Handspring. 1.5. In a pike position and... There, the half twist, 1.5 somersaults, of course, because she's coming from her hands. But that is a beautifully executed vault. Feet held tightly together, sliding the arms elegantly down by her side for the half twist. And Lavinia Milosevic hauled herself up into second position. Olympic champion on floor. But with that last vault that Podkopayeva has put in, it's going to be very, very close between these two. Octavian Bellew standing on the sidelines, encouraging the audience to clap, but that was really a bad wobble for her. Out of the double pirouette. Milosevic really is carrying some extra weight. 2.5 twist punch front. Still the good tumbler that she always was. Well, the hand touch in the final tumble, the full in back out, will have cost her the silver medal because she'll drop down. I can't see anybody else climbing up that far, but it's going to cost her. In second position, and she'll undoubtedly drop down from the second position. It could even cost her more. Stovbchataya from the Ukraine. Her first vault. She's had a good round of scores, 9.5.1.2 on asymmetric bars, 9.7.6.2 on the beam, so we'll see her in the beam final. And 9.5.1.2 on floor. Yurchenko, full twist, a little bit slack around the knees, but solid. A very sure vault.
9.6.3.7
for the first, second to come, and then her score will be the average of the two. And this is very important for her because she could squeeze into a medal position. Solid, but was it good enough? She could so very easily overhaul Milosevic after her bad floor. There's the slow-mo, but decidedly slack around the knees. Fabrichnova still in the lead, Podkopayeva second, and Milosevic dropped into third with Stovbchataya in fourth position. But still the last performances and the most exciting ones to come for the champion to be decided. Join us again.
Eurosport.
Maya Shani from Israel. Her fourth piece, the vault, but I think that already she knows who's the winner. Fabrichnova already having reached a score of 38.693. Handspring, 1.5 somersaults with half twist. A nice long vault, but just not too steady on the landing. See all the lines on the run-up mat where the gymnasts actually measure the length of their run. They know whether their run is 17.3 meters long and a big toe length. They have it all worked out. First score, 9.625. Second vault to come. Long vault. Judges looking for height and length. And Maya trying to get in the top 10, and she'll have really done herself justice. And I think into the bargain, she could well get into the vault final if she produces anywhere near a reasonable second score. Although it's going to be very close. Tanja Pechstein from Switzerland on floor. Thank you. Tanja Pechstein from Switzerland finishing there with a double tuck. And very difficult for these last gymnasts in the rotation because they know that the championship in effect has been decided. But of course, on a personal level, they still have the opportunity to get into the individual apparatus final. The top eight on each piece of apparatus go forward for the individual apparatus finals tomorrow. And there, Benedict Everard from Belgium competing her handspring front in the piked position. Difficult somersault to land because it's blind. Always better if they can improve the vault so that they can get that half twist on and actually see where the floor is. But very difficult to spot a forward rotating movement, especially from that speed and height. Nine, 5.87 for her first vault. And Maya Shani scored 9.643 for her average of the two. And Everard just managing to get a little more rotation on that second vault, but still stepping forwards. But as I stressed, a very difficult vault to land. And there's her average, 9.587, and her total score, putting her 37.649. And all the little Belgian gymnasts wanting their heroine's autograph. Of course, Belgian champion and very popular. Svetlana Ivanova from Bulgaria. We haven't seen much of her. Bulgarians have a terrific reputation for good choreography of the dance sections on the floor. She's just a little bit ahead of the music though, having to fill in. Just stepping out of the floor area on that final tumble. Svetlana Ivanova.
Svetlana Ivanova.
8.787 on asymmetric bars for her 8.987 on the beam.
There.
The final tumble, triple twist. It was actually 2 3/4. And somebody's mascot was in the picture there. Yurchenko with a full twist from Ekaterina Vandysheva. But unfortunately, that fall on beam cost her. She dropped right down to 9.15. And without that fall, it would have been a 9.65 or 9.7. So that put her out of the all-around event, but we'll see her in some apparatus finals.
9.61.
9.612 for her first fault.
Sorry, 9.612.
Slightly off-center on the landing, but certainly made sure of it. Not a good camera position to actually be able to judge it from. But that, in fact, the last performance of the day. Ekaterina Vandysheva finishing on vault.
Vandysheva.
And it. A Yurchenko with a full twist. Well, we've seen some splendid gymnastics today. And the overall winner, Oksana Fabrichnova from Russia, scored 38.693. Podkopayeva from the Ukraine, a close second with 38.637. And Lavinia Milosovici just keeping in the medals with 38.474. But we'll see some of the gymnasts repeating some of their wonderful performances in the individual apparatus finals tomorrow, alongside the men in the individual apparatus finals also. So do join us for Eurosport's coverage from the continuation of the European Cup individual apparatus finals. So hopefully we'll see you tomorrow. From me, Monica Phelps, and Eurosport, goodbye.